Hey, Spencer here with BuilderFunnel, and I'm excited to announce this year's launch of the State of Home Builder Marketing Report for 2020. Here are this year's top takeaways. So when it comes to marketing, there's a wide range of activities and tactics that builders and marketers for builders are leveraging. But there are a few things that everyone agrees on. One of those is more consistent social media posting. 27% of builder marketers said that they post less than a few times a week. Last year, that number was 38%. So more and more people are posting more frequently to social media. Another area is in blogging. So last year, half of builder marketers said that they blog occasionally or never. And that number has reduced to 36% this year. So what that tells us is that more and more builder marketers have recognized, hey, I need to be creating content. I need to be building up my SEO value on my website. And so they're getting into the regular content creation game. So the other thing it seems like everybody agrees on is that you have to have some element of experimentation and testing. For the most part, we're seeing the same social media channels being used. Facebook, Instagram, House, those types of platforms. But we're starting to see some new areas where people are diving into things like TikTok and podcasting. So as you think about your marketing strategy, remember it's always important to invest in the things that are working, but you do have to have some level of experimentation and testing to make sure you stay relevant and you catch any of those trends that are about to pop. So what are builder marketers avoiding when it comes to marketing tactics? By a wide margin, the top thing is paid advertising. Now this refers to offline paid advertising. But next on the list was online paid advertising, things like PR and print collateral. So if you're still focused on those things, you might want to take another look and see if those things are actually providing a return or they're adding value in the sales process or somewhere in the marketing process. On the sales front, the top priorities, there were two big ones. One is generating leads and the other was closing leads. So not a big surprise there, but coming in as the top preferred marketing channel, 39% of builder marketers said that inbound marketing provides the highest quality leads for their organization. Let's talk about some of the mistakes that builder marketers are making. The top mistake seems to be centered around reviewing analytics and measuring performance. So what are the big mistakes that builder marketers are making? According to the report and our findings, 43% of builder marketers look at their analytics weekly or more often, which is great. But on the flip side, 57% said that they're looking at it less often or oftentimes not at all. And so what we also found is that 40% of builder marketers don't know the ROI on their marketing channels, and so they don't know where to invest and where to cut, and they're flying blind. So the big takeaway here is make sure that you're measuring your marketing efforts and putting those things in place and then looking at the analytics on a regular basis so that you can improve. Those were our top takeaways from this year's State of Home Builder Marketing Report for 2020. And if you want to take a deeper dive, go ahead and download the report below. Thanks for watching.